In dealing with that today, negotiating with a credit card company, joining us now with some tips, Matt Schulz of comparecards.com. Matt, you say all you have to do is just ask. What do you mean?
Ultimately, it's like my dad has told me practically my whole life. It never hurts to ask.
Do people really have power over their credit card company?
People have way more power over their credit card issuer than they think they do, but way too few people actually wield that power. Oftentimes, all it takes to get a fee waived is a phone call. That's especially true if you were late with a payment, you got charged a fee, and this is the first time that it's happened to you in a long time, or maybe ever. It really just takes a polite phone call to your credit card issuer.
You took a survey, and what did you learn about late fees?
Our survey showed that it's really easy to get a late fee waived. About 90% of people were successful, but other negotiations may take a little bit of work. They're still worth doing, no question, but they may take a little bit of work. For example, we found that about 80% of people who asked for a lower interest rate got their request granted, and that can save you hundreds of dollars, if not more, over the course of your loan if you carry a balance on a regular basis. It's a really big deal.
What are your personal tips for negotiating with a credit card company?
If you're nervous about how to negotiate that lower APR, here's one way to do it. Find a card that you know that you qualify for at a site like comparecards.com, or maybe through an offer that you received in your snail mail, and use that offer to frame the conversation with the credit card issuer. You can go to them and say, "Hey, I've had your card for a while, I really like it, and I've been a good customer, but I have a 20% APR, and I just got offered a card with a 17% APR. Would you be able to match that?"
Why do you think it is more people don't try to negotiate?
Most people don't call and ask for these breaks because they didn't know that they could. But also, a lot of people just don't think that they'll be successful, and still other folks are just nervous about confrontation and negotiation. Well, I'm here to tell you that whatever your reason is for not making that call, you should probably ignore that instinct that you have or that nervousness. Make the call, because your chances of success are really, really high. And you can save yourself some real money.
Thank you so much, Matt, for your tips.
Always good to talk with you, Angie.
For more Business First AM, check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.